Here we have a linear function, g of x equals negative one-third x. If you want, you can rewrite that as y equals negative one-third x. You can even put the plus zero if you want, so that it looks like it's in slope-intercept form. In that form, you can tell what the slope is. Just by inspection, the slope here is negative one-third. Okay, remember, that's your rise over run. The y-intercept, well, that'll always occur when x is 0, and the y would be, the corresponding y would be 0. So the origin is the y-intercept. Once you have the y-intercept and the slope, you're ready to graph it. Okay, so here's my y-axis. And let's make the x-axis here. All right. So negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. 1 would be up there. So there's my blank Cartesian coordinate system where the y-axis, I'm going to call it g of x. Okay, so let's graph it up. Always start at the y-intercept, in this case 0, 0. We're going to mark off from there, we're going to mark off the slope. So down 1. Negative 1, rise, and a 3 run will get you that second point over here. 3 comma negative 1. 2 points of terminal line. So once you mark off the slope, just connect the dots. Use a straight edge, and there you go.